The operating system is going to be very different depending on whether the business produces a good or a service. So, let's take a Coca-Cola as an example. It takes a bunch of inputs, it transforms them to produce an output. So does a hospital or an emergency department or a doctor or a lawyer, any type of service. They take a bunch of inputs, they transform it, and they produce some outputs. But I guess those products are very different. So for a good, it's tangible. You can see it, you can touch it. So for example, an iPhone or a Coca-Cola. A service though is intangible. There's elements of it that you can see, but fundamentally, when you're going to the hospital or the doctor, for example, you're being treated. You can't really see that. You're just it's intangible. You can't see it and touch it. With goods, they're usually all the same. So every bottle of Coca-Cola around the world is the same size, the same shape, with the same ingredients, etc. Whereas with services, they're all usually unique. So every doctor's consultation, even for two patients, say with a similar issue, say a cold, the appointment is still going to be different in terms of how the questions are asked, the specific medicine that's recommended, and so on. So every service is usually tailored to the needs of each particular patient or customer. Goods involve a lot of machines to make. They're going to be what we call capital intensive. Whereas services, whilst they are machines, they're more labor intensive. Your main biggest input is the knowledge of the people performing the service. So we end up with some differences whether we're producing a Coke or a hamburger, shoes or bread, versus a doctor, a hairdresser, a lawyer, a landscape gardener, a veterinarian, etc. So looking at how they're different, the operation systems, we're going to compare a bottle of Coke with a doctor's consultation. So one thing is, yeah, the tangible or not tangible. So bottle of Coca-Cola has a physical form, whereas a service, the actual consultation doesn't have a physical form as such. So with the consumer and a bottle of Coke, you can go up to a friend after you've bought it, and if they say, "Show me what you bought," you can go, "This bottle of Coca-Cola right here." Whereas with a service, like a doctor, for example, if you go to a friend afterwards and the friend says, "Show me the doctor's consultation that you got," that doesn't really make any sense. It's intangible. Then we've got production and consumption. With a bottle of Coca-Cola, production and consumption occur separately. There's two events. The product is produced by the business, and then it's usually stored in inventory. Second event is that the customer then buys it and it's consumed later on. So let's take a bottle of Coke. Let's say, for example, it was made on 11th of February. It's put into storage and it's not consumed until, say, the 17th of March. There's like 6 weeks there in between when that product was made and when it was consumed. Even products with a very short shelf life, like bread, for example, there is a delay between when they're made and when they're consumed. That is different to a service. There's only really one event, and that's because production and consumption occur simultaneously. You make an appointment with the doctor on the 11th of February, you consume or that product is produced on the 11th of February. It's not stored in inventory for later. Next one is purchasing and consumption. With a bottle of Coke, these can also occur different separately and be different people. So for example, a customer purchases the good. The consumer is the one who actually consumes or uses the good. They can be different people. So for example, you might buy a bottle of Coke and give it to a friend. There is a difference between who purchased the good and who consumed the good. Whereas a doctor's consultation, that purchasing and consumption occurs simultaneously and usually by the same person. So the customer and the consumer are the same person. So if you go to the doctor, you're the one that buys that product in this case, and you're also the one who consumes it. Another difference is storable. This is a big one for operations, and it's going to affect a lot of things that the business does. For a good, yes, the product is storable. It can be stored in inventory for sale later on. So we don't just make one Coca-Cola at a time. We make hundreds of millions a day around the world, and they're stored in inventory before they're sold. That is different to the output from a service. The output has no physical form and can't be stored for later. So you can't make a doctor's appointment earlier and then sort of put it on the shelf and bring it out for a customer in a couple of days. That doesn't make any sense. Then we've got standardized or customized. A bottle of Coke is standardized, same shape, same color, same taste, same ingredients everywhere around the world. Okay, it doesn't really matter where you buy it from, any country around the world. That's the point of it, it tastes the same. Whereas we said a doctor's service, we're going to use the word customized. They're produced one at a time, not in mass quantities. And each version of the product is unique and changes the needs of the individual client. So a doctor sees several patients a day. Every one of those consultations is slightly different, and it's all based on the needs of the individual client. We've also got customer, or the customer contact. With a good, there's usually minimal contact between the producer of the good and the customer and final consumer. So Coca-Cola, you have actually never bought a Coca-Cola from Coca-Cola. It doesn't work that way. What happens instead is that they sell it, say, to 7-Eleven, and you buy it from 7-Eleven. So there's actually no contact between you and the producer of Coca-Cola. And most goods are like that. Whereas a doctor's consultation is very different. There's a high degree of contact, a lot of human interaction between the producer of the product or the service and the customer and final consumer. You can't have a doctor's consultation without having human contact with the doctor. And lastly, we've got sort of the intensity of production. With a bottle of Coke, a product is produced, whereas with a service, the product is kind of more performed. It's not really produced as such. It's a performance or a display of services. And therefore, a bottle of Coke or a good is capital intensive. We need a lot of machines. Whereas a doctor's consultation or a service, say a haircut, for example, you're relying on the labor, the human skill and effort. So Coca-Cola, we can see mass amount of machinery there, no humans. I can see over 1,000 bottles of Coca-Cola and not one human. You're not going to have that with a service. You're going to need to see the person performing the service will be in the picture of that product. So in this case, a doctor with a child. And also that means some things for in terms of, can we measure product quality and productivity with a good like Coca-Cola? Yes, we can easily. They should all be the same. Whereas it's very different, very difficult to measure the product quality and productivity of a service. And we'll get to that in the next lesson.